Hi everyone, Kelly here. I wanted to show you my favorite watercolor palette. It's a Mead & Porcelain 9-Well palette. It cleans up really, really well. It's a great size. It measures approximately just under 7 inches long and just a little over 3¼ inches wide. I also like the color of this palette because it matches my favorite watercolor paper. It's not a bright white palette, which I've read some reviews that complained about that, but honestly, I think it's better not to be so white since your paper's not that white. I got this palette at Amazon for about $13.99, which I think is a pretty good deal for what you're getting. With all of these little wells, you have the ability to mix up different colors and solutions for consistent washes. And to me, that beats a plain plate, which works just as well as far as mixing colors. But just having these extra wells, having them separate, really helps me to keep a clean look to my paintings when that's what I'm looking for. So really like to use this palette in conjunction with this other one. It's called the Bright Creations palette. And I also got in on Amazon for $13.99. And I'll put a link for both of these in the description. And also Irit Landgraft is another YouTuber. She got this palette at the same time I did. I was gonna do a review on it, but she did a really nice review on it. So I don't wanna go over it too much. Other than she said she couldn't fit her other metal pieces into hers. Probably there's a little variation, but mine fit. Mine was from one of the Mead & metal palettes. And I just really like to be able to remove the wells or the little pans and change them out and still be able to keep the colors that I use all the time in the big wells, and you can use those for bigger brushes too. It's just a great palette. The one thing it doesn't have, obviously, is a ceramic palette, but guess what we can do? We can fit this Mead & ceramic palette right in the little section here. I just love that. And it fits right in together, right on my desk. Doesn't take up too much space. Now, also this palette, that little tray does not stay in when you close it, which actually works pretty well for me because what I like to do is, after, you know, while my watercolors are still wet, I would rather leave them open so they can dry out a little bit, but I also don't want dust on them. So I just take that little tray back out and place it over them while they're drying. And then when they're dry, I just close them back up and it's all good. So I can't think of a better combination of those two palettes. They work really, really well for me. So if you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe and hit the notifications bell. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.